让我想一想。Can you talk about this drawing you are copying?
This is a master study again after the great artist Leonardo da Vinci. This drawing is super beautiful for me, very attractive for me because it's pink, basically because the color is pink, and I am doing experiments with color pencil this period of time, and I hope I could make it beautifully, but in a different way, because when you are copy a masterpiece, you don't have to be exactly the same as that work. If you look at the thing objectively, very honestly, you could never be the same as that work. Even though the artist do the work one more time, make a second version, a third version, each piece will be slightly different. He make it different deliberately, because every time you do a drawing, it's a journey. It's a beautiful journey, like a small, you go to a new place, or you revisit somewhere you're familiar with, but you look at it from a different angle, a different perspective. it's different. How much I wish for I could draw exactly the same as the original piece to show my high respect to that work and to that artist. But I realize no one can be exactly the same, especially it's a hyper complicated drawing with so much details to take care of. And you have to be very cautious all the time. But again, it's always good to do this study, master study, especially when you have some questions in your mind and the picture wouldn't talk to you verbally. But if you if you're copying it, you are really looking at every single detail, a lot more detailed than just take a look for a couple of minutes. Maybe some highly technical experts could do it, but I think back to the very beginning of this work is the reason. The reason is I like this drawing, and I really like it, so I want to feel how it's done, the process, how it's done, my own way. There are some beautiful master copies in the art history, some artists. My real life, I've seen some people doing master copies very they are really trying their best, and they are really eager, and they are the the one to enjoy the joy. The joy is when you are really eager with your drawing, no matter the level it is. That is the key word, the password of being happy with your drawing, only when you really like it. Although it may get difficult and the picture may get tough because there are some fundamental training problems in it, but if it's good, it's always worth your time to investigate furthermore and more and more. I was swimming yesterday, and I was swimming in the pool, and I recall my drawing, and I realized that is a fabric drawing, and I realized that the left edge, the lower part, needs to be darker. When I'm swimming, I suddenly realized I was thinking of that drawing, and that amazed me for that second. Usually with music, but that second, my drawing jumped into my mind and tell me the left edge part needs to be darker. And I come back and do it. It's almost like the drawing tell me what to do, but it's tricky. Obviously, I am the person doing the drawing. I'm the real activity here, and the drawing is silent. But it sometimes feels like if you met a beautiful work, it surprises you and it talks to you in a way, not verbally, of course. How much I wish for I never learn speaking any language and just look at pictures and draw and look and draw and feel. Well, maybe I'll become an idiot if I could not talk at all, but maybe I'll get super sensitive about visual language, colors, dark and light, this kind of mystical things in art. I'm going to do that copy for 10 times, and at last I'll do a work only with memory, and to see how much I have learned from that piece, how deep I have gone into it. Because when you draw something by memory, even not look, that's what you have understood in your mind, and you do it logically and very hyper principle. But in the process, I'll take a break time to time to do some other pieces slowly, a little bit by a little bit, so I won't get tired of that piece. I do some other things to prevent me from getting tired of my drawing. It is tricky. It doesn't mean you are no longer love drawing. It doesn't mean that. It just has its own path. It's like a turning hose. The passion comes back to you time to time, and not always with you. So when you feel a little bit low, I think it's very, very effective and useful to do little bit other things and then come back to your main theme very fast. Take a sleep, that really helps a lot. And not consider verbal things so much anymore, unless you're writing an essay, huh? You're doing a report, or you're talking with your artist friends. The language will never run away from you. You will summarize her answer immediately very well because while you are drawing, even though you are mute, even though you are silent, you are growing, pencil growing, your mind growing. So don't worry about me. I'm really okay. About this one, I only wish for I could find a 0.3 color pencil leads for my mechanical pencil just to save time. I wish for some high quality 0.3 colorful pencil leads, basically just orange and brown and some other colors, basic, very basic colors. Reality can make me very silent, but drawing can really make me humble and not tamed. Tamed seems like be scared by some great powerful things, scary things, but humble is a noble word. It's when you see a beautiful work, the work not shock to you, but be with you for that moment, and you will feel the harmony and the beautiful existing of the artist staying with you for a moment, if you are really humble, really eager with his work. So you will feel that person almost. It sounds difficult, it sounds impossible, right? But that's what I felt when I'm doing copy from great masters and from contemporary artists. Some people think I'm wasting time. I should do my own real work. That's correct from one aspect. I'll do my work, of course, but I also fascinated with this copy. Sometimes it takes a while to get back to my balance, to my passion, to my creativity or eagerness, something. You need to take a break to get it. And it always worth the, like if you really feel bad, headache, sleep for a while and come back to your drawing, it's totally okay. This lead stuck here. Okay, that's it.